Well, 10 years ago today, the MH17 disaster stunned the world and left an indelible scar on the families of the victims. 38 Australians died when the Malaysian Airlines flight was shot out of the sky over Ukraine, among them Toowoomba couple Jill and Roger Gard.
Before boarding the flight, the Gards had been exploring Europe, and Jill's sister Liz and her husband Malcolm Garrett were all together. Today's Sylvia Jeffries sat down with the Garretts to reflect on a family's lost decade.
I think that's my favourite photo of the two sisters.
It was a special one.
Liz and Mal Garrett treasure the happy mementos from their last holiday with Liz's sister, Jill Gard, and her husband, Roger.
What are your memories from that trip?
Well, we've travelled a lot together and we were very compatible for, so every holiday was lovely. But this one was, I don't know, just everything was perfect.
The two couples embraced their passion for food and history on a European river cruise. After initially planning to travel home together, Mal and Liz extended their trip, saying goodbye to Jill and Roger in Belgium, a moment now imprinted on their minds.
Do you remember saying goodbye to them the day you parted ways?
I do.
I'm sorry.
I was at the train station. At Ghent?
Ghent.
And they went back to Amsterdam and we went on to Paris.
Were they happy that day?
Oh, ecstatically happy, I think. It had been the most beautiful trip.
On the 17th of June 2014, Jill and Roger were among 298 people to board Malaysia Airlines flight MH17 in Amsterdam. They were bound for Kuala Lumpur, but never made it. A missile struck the plane over eastern Ukraine, killing everyone on board, including 38 Australians.
When we got that phone call, we were sort of paralysed. We couldn't speak. It's a bit like, I don't know whether you've ever been hit in the elbow and the pain has been so much that your breath has been totally taken away. Well, that's what it felt like.
Three men, backed by Russia, were sentenced to life in jail for the devastating war crime. Australian authorities determined to see justice for the victims and their families.
The people who dealt with us were very compassionate. Julie Bishop was amazing in the way in which she prosecuted the whole thing and you know, wanted to get to the bottom of who was responsible.
As Mal and Liz mark the 10th anniversary of the disaster, they are once again confronting their grief.
It's the sort of thing that it just wells up, you know, and you never know when it's going to hit you.
I think the hardest day for me was attending their youngest son David's wedding in New Zealand in 2019, and just suddenly hit me that they were missing out on occasion when they should have been a central part of it.
Oh, may the sunflowers in Ukraine turn callous hearts so they can see that love alone has moral force.
Mal, a former English teacher, has found solace in poetry, penning an anthology as a tribute to his brother and sister-in-law.
How could unfeeling fate conspire to bring them to such senseless harm?
And dedicating the proceeds to the people of Ukraine.
I don't think that we'll ever get over the MH17 incident until the war is brought to a conclusion.
Mal will recite one of his poems at a commemorative service in Canberra today, where he and Liz will join other families to honour the ones they loved.
When we were travelling, Roger was very interested in history, very interesting fellow. Jill, she was very artistic.
She was a very generous person.
She used to say to the children, if you're having a bad day, just think of something that you can do for somebody else and that'll make it much better. And that's the sort of person she was.
Beautiful tribute, isn't it?
Yeah, lovely interview from Sylvia. And just the pain that goes on and on for them and not being able to, as a parent or a loved one, to find out the answers just adds to that frustration.
Yeah, with the complexities of the war still going on, as they said.